So we see now that the battle last night between Babyface and Teddy Riley was a complete mess. An absolute mess, okay? These two legends were supposed to compete and battle it out on Instagram Live, and it was a mess. Now, I don't know if you guys knew this, but Teddy Riley, he gave us a warning. He told us about a week, 2 weeks ago. He said that he wanted to put on a show. He didn't want it to be on Instagram Live. He wanted to put on a streamed show with better audio, production, the whole nine. But, you know, Timbaland and Swiss Beats and everybody online said, no, no, you doing too much. No, don't do that. Let's just keep it, you know, how it's been going on Instagram Live. I mean, that's what people love about these battles, is the fact that it's so organic. There's no production, lighting, and crews and all of that. It's just straight up organic. These celebrities with these hits that we admire so much, just at home, chilling like we are, you know, entertaining us. That's what is the good. I mean, that's what we love about these lives. But Teddy said, no, I want to give y'all a show, right? People thought this was the reason why it took so long to get them together to do this, but it wasn't. Actually, Babyface said that he had the coronavirus, so he was recuperating from that. So now he all good. They hop on live last night, and it was a mess. I didn't watch it live. I'm seeing the recaps and stuff this morning because I knew what was happening, what was going to happen, and I wasn't trying to waste my time. Over 400,000 people tuned in, and the audio was bad. The picture quality was horrible. There were some points where we couldn't hear Teddy. And Babyface, he was there with his phone and his laptop. He was ready to go. But Teddy, he had a whole crew behind the scenes, and it was bad. Here's where he messed up, and this is what he should have done. And artist, I need you guys to take notes. He should have done something that a lot of business people have done and are currently doing now, since we're at home bored, in the house bored, and just, you know, trying to kill time, and some folks out there trying to make a few dollars. But he should have hopped his butt on Instagram Live with his phone and his laptop and battled it out. And then at the end, get that traffic over to his website so that way he can get people to sign up for a live, high production show streaming on his actual website. Okay, so he should have had the live battle, been done with that. Oh, thank y'all so much for tuning in. What I want to do is have y'all go to my website, Teddy Vision, whatever his website is, teddyriley.com, whatever. And, you know, I'm going to put on a show for y'all, a private show for y'all this weekend. Go over there, sign up, charge them a couple bucks or whatever, give them a discount or something for tuning in. And now he got the traffic, put on the production at his house, live stream that the next weekend. But no. What he actually did last night, which is what caused the issue, was that he was trying to stream this show on Instagram Live as well as his website. So the stream on his website, it had good audio, good video, picture, everything. But what we saw on Instagram Live was horrible, which was where all the people were at. He was trying to kill two birds with one stone. And sometimes that's nice. It's cool to kill two birds with one stone. But in this instance, he should have separated the two and just use the Instagram Live as a lead magnet to get those leads, get those people over to his website, and then convert them over into the live stream show the following weekend. Business people do this all the time, and you guys have seen it. They advertise these free webinars to us on Facebook and Instagram. I actually hate it, to be honest. This is why I never done it, even though people told me to do it or advised me to do it, but I never done it. I hate them. But that's another video. But we see it all the time. People are doing these videos and run these ads for you to sign up for their free webinar. And then at the end of the webinar, they're trying to get you to sign up to a course or something, a $1,000, $2,000, $15,000 course. I'm exaggerating. But this high-ass course, and they could break it down into payments and all this other stuff. That's what they use these free webinars for. So it's a strategy, a sales funnel, and a sales strategy that a lot of businesses use. And Teddy Riley should have done the same thing with his Instagram. And it could have worked because it's music. We all love music, and he's Teddy Riley. It could have worked. It really could have. So this is the lesson here that a lot of artists need to learn, is that it is very important that you guys have good people on your team. Not just good, but knowledgeable, strategic, and tech savvy people on your team, so they can set you up to be displayed and presented to the world in the best light. Because now look at the blogs, look at the internet. Yeah, he's trending, but this is not good. It's not good. And sometimes bad press isn't always good press. I don't care what they say. Sometimes bad press isn't good press. And I just hate to see this legend be disrespected and talked about in such a negative light when all this could have been avoided.